I welcome you all to my YouTube channel Insight into Chemical Engineering. In this lecture series, we will solve the unsolved problem of a famous book, Stoichiometry and Process Calculations by K.V. Narayan. These lectures are helpful for chemical engineering students because process calculations is a core subject for chemical engineering branch. During lecture, step-by-step solution will be provided. In this lecture, exercise number 4.14 to 4.18 will be covered. Please like and subscribe for motivation. Problem number 4.14. A cooking gas cylinder can withstand a maximum pressure of 15 atm and the pressure gauge of the cylinder indicates 12 atm at 300 Kelvin. During a sudden fire in the building, the temperature starts rising. At what temperature will this cylinder explode? So we can use ideal gas equation at the initial condition and at the final condition just before explosion. So at initial condition, we can write P1V1 equal to N1RT1. So at initial condition, pressure equal to 12 atm and temperature equal to 300 Kelvin. Now we can assume that the cylinder will explode at temperature T2. So corresponding to that temperature, pressure will be 15 atm. Now again we can write P2V2 equal to N2RT2. Now in both equation, the volume and number of moles will remain same. Now we can simply divide the both equation and we can solve it for T2. So temperature will come out as 375 Kelvin. Problem number 4.15. Calculate the volume occupied at 400 Kelvin and 2 atm pressure by the gas evolved from 2 ml of solid CO2 and density of solid CO2 is given. So we can use ideal gas equation. So in order to estimate volume, temperature and pressure are given. So if the number of moles are known, then we can easily estimate the volume. So we will start with solid CO2. So volume of solid CO2 is given, that is 2 ml. And using density, we can estimate the mass of solid CO2. And then we can convert this mass to number of moles. Then this number of moles can be used during calculation. So volume of solid CO2 equal to 2 ml. Convert this ml to liter and liter to meter cube. We can write density equal to mass per unit volume. Now density of solid is known and volume of solid CO2 is also known. So we can easily estimate the mass of solid CO2. So it will come out as 3 gram. Now we can find out the moles of CO2. So moles of CO2 will be equal to given weight of CO2 divided by its molecular weight. So these are the number of moles of CO2. So same solid CO2 got converted into gas. So number of moles will remain same. Now we can use the ideal gas equation and we can write V equal to nRT by P. Now everything are known, so we can easily estimate the volume. So volume will come out as 1.1198 liter. In this case, we are using the value of R as 0.0821 because we are taking pressure in term of atm, so volume will come out as in term of liter. Problem number 4.16. A vessel of volume 0.02 meter cube contains a mixture of hydrogen and helium at certain temperature and pressure. The mass of the mixture is 10 gram, means mass of hydrogen plus mass of helium equal to 10 gram. Calculate the individual masses of hydrogen and helium in the mixture. So we already got one equation, that is mass of hydrogen plus mass of helium equal to 10 gram. So we need one more equation so that we can solve it for mass of hydrogen and mass of helium. Using ideal gas equation, we can also get one more equation. So as per problem, mass of hydrogen plus mass of helium equal to 10 gram. We are calling it as equation number 1. Now we will find out the total moles of mixture using ideal gas law, because volume, temperature and pressure are given, so we can write the formula N equal to PV by RT. Now pressure is known, volume is known, temperature is known. So number of moles will come out as 3.118 mole. Now we can write total number of moles equal to moles of H2 plus moles of helium, that is mole balance. Now further we can write mole in term of weight, because number of moles equal to weight divided by molecular weight. So we can simply write number of moles of H2 equal to weight of H2 divided by its molecular weight. In the same way, number of moles of helium can be written as mass of helium divided by its molecular weight, and it should be equal to 3.118, and we are calling it as equation number 2. Now we have two unknown and two equation. So using equation 1 and 2, we can estimate the mass of H2 and mass of helium. Now on solving, we will get mass of helium equal to 2.47 gram and mass of hydrogen equal to 7.53 gram. Problem number 4.17. The flow rate of a gas mixture consisting of 60% ethane, 25% hydrogen and 15% carbon dioxide is found to be 200 meter cube per hour at 300 Kelvin and 1.2 bar. So part A, determine the composition of gas in weight percentage. We know to estimate weight percentage, weight of individual gas and weight of total gas should be known. So how we can estimate the weight of individual gases? So initially the flow rate is given, that is 200 meter cube per hour. So we can take 1 hour as our basis, and then accordingly we can do the calculation. So basis is 1 hour, and first we will estimate the total number of moles of gas mixture, because volume, temperature and pressure are known. So using ideal gas equation, we can estimate the total number of moles of gas mixture. So PV equal to nRT. So N can be written as PV by RT. So simply plug in the values of P, V and T So we will get N equal to 9.622 kilomole. Now for part A, we need to estimate the mass of individual gases. But in the problem, it is given that gas mixture consisting of 60% ethane, 25% hydrogen and 15% CO2 by volume percentage. And we know for gases, volume percentage and mole percentage are same. And we have estimated total number of moles. So we can simply write number of moles of ethane will be equal to 60% of total number of moles. So it will come out as 5.773 kilomole. So in the same way, we can write moles of hydrogen will be equal to 25% of total moles. And moles of CO2 will be equal to 15% of total moles. Now we can estimate the mass of ethane. So mass of ethane will be equal to moles of ethane, that is 5.773 kilomole, into its molecular weight. So it will come out as 173.19 kg. So in the same way, we can estimate the mass of hydrogen and mass of carbon dioxide. Now we can write total weight equal to mass of ethane plus mass of hydrogen plus mass of CO2. Now we can write weight percentage of ethane equal to weight of ethane divided by total weight into 100. Now everything are known, so we can easily estimate the weight percentage of ethane. It will come out as 71.72%. Now in the same way, we can estimate the weight percentage of H2 and weight percentage of CO2. So in part B, we need to express the composition in term of mole per liter. So for this case, the volume is known. So convert this meter cube to liter, and number of moles we have already estimated in part A using ideal gas equation. So we can write concentration of C2H6 equal to moles of C2H6 divided by total volume. So it will come out as 0.0288. So in the same way, we can estimate the concentration of H2 and concentration of CO2, and units will be in term of mole per liter. So in part C, we were supposed to estimate the flow rate. Flow rate equal to mass per unit time. So we have already assumed 1 hour as our basis. So simply we will divide the total weight by 1 hour. So this total weight per hour will become equal to the flow rate. Problem number 4.18. 2 cubic meters of oxygen at 200 kilopascal and 280 Kelvin is mixed with 10 kg of nitrogen at different temperature and pressure, and the resulting mixture is brought to certain temperature and pressure conditions. Part A, what is the partial pressure of oxygen in the final mixture? So we need to estimate the partial pressure of oxygen in the final mixture. So using Dalton's law, we can estimate the partial pressure. We know that partial pressure of oxygen divided by total pressure will be equal to mole fraction of oxygen in that mixture. So first we need to estimate the total moles of gas mixture as well as individual moles of oxygen and nitrogen. So for this case, it is given that oxygen is present at 200 kilopascal and 280 Kelvin and volume is given. So using ideal gas equation, we can estimate the moles of oxygen. So first we will estimate the moles of oxygen using ideal gas equation. So we can simply plug in the values and we will get 171.83 mole. Now we can estimate the moles of N2. For N2 it is given 10 kg of nitrogen. So we can write moles equal to weight divided by its molecular weight. So we can easily estimate the number of moles of N2. Now in part A, we are getting this resultant mixture by mixing oxygen and nitrogen gases. So we can simply do the mole balance. So total number of moles of gas mixture will be equal to moles of O2 plus moles of N2. So total moles will be equal to 528.97 mole. Now according to Dalton's law, we can write partial pressure of oxygen divided by total pressure equal to mole fraction of oxygen, and mole fraction can be written as moles of oxygen divided by total moles. Now in this case the total pressure is known and moles of oxygen will be equal to 171.83 and total moles will be equal to 528.97. So by putting all values, we can easily estimate the partial pressure of oxygen and it will be equal to 35.73 kilopascal. Now in part B, we need to estimate the final volume of the mixture. So for this case, temperature and pressure are known and total number of moles we have already estimated. So using simple ideal gas equation, we can estimate the volume. So V will be equal to nRT by P. Simply plug in all values and we will get 11.59 meter cube.